and sing for him. Are we there?
We're there. Let me start.
We'll sing one after the other. Then, as you are singing, no, that's the one that you are included here. Join 5 p.m. next level prayer. If I wake up, I'll make sure I pray. since that day. And if you are coming to my house, I will tell you so time. We need to break nonsense. I'll tell you don't carry your bad luck to my house. So he has been a mentor to me. He has been he has been someone that I felt his impact. Not as a friend, just as a normal member, I felt his impact on his stretch. So before that week's run, I came out of those depths that I could look around, if I look at the compound, I come out, I talk to anybody, I owe nobody nothing. So that thing alone is a plus to me. And I thank God for his encouragement. He has been teaching me, you know, making me grow in faith, making me grow spiritually. And all I want to say is, Bro Ope, thank you very much. You carry my matter for air.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So,
for you, right?
Yes. Thank you. So, I want to say much. I think I knew when I put for you, I was here. So, Abby? Yeah, he has been my same member, but now he's not a leader too. So, I did not train him. He trained me. Yes. So he also privileged to be in the same department as HSDC. So something I like about him. Is committed and he do commit himself to so many activities. So I always tell the brother, calm down. Brother, calm down. I've been this thing before. Calm down. You know, so I think the worst encounter I had with him was, you know, he came to send me things and I was in cell. You know, people would throw questions to you and I would answer the question one by one. The next one he came and I said, I'm coming back to this cell because of this brother. the way he scattered the word, you know, from that day I knew I had people that could have to tell me that were praying with words. You know, sometimes as a pastor, when you preach and you don't have a prayer, you might discourage. But it was part of the reason that I didn't encourage me. Even though when the Spirit of God works for us, he needs encouragement. He needs encouragement and also supported my ministry. Because I had a lot of activities. So I want to tell them, Mr. Let me do this. Even though I carry the whole matter on my head, he knows whether I collect something to do this by ourselves. You know, always in there. Then we move from HSDC to maturity campaign, and we're still doing it. So, do it to God, you are still standing.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. He's my trainer. Okay, who else?
No, that's up.
Okay.
What's right?
Yeah, let's see like this.
Because Santa Claus doesn't really know me.
She's new.
So she can say something.
I won't really say I know for a very long time, but what I would say is that the time I have spent with him, many in the church, those times have been spirit lifting. Because there's this day that, there's this day after church, I didn't know why he actually stopped me. And then we started talking. So he was telling me about this message that he listened. When he was explaining it, in my mind I'm like, why is this guy telling me this? I already know what he's listening. So, but there was a statement he made that till today, he has never left me, and that word, I think God just wanted me to hear it. So he really rang a special bell. So since that time, anytime he stops me, I'm Sharon, I'm stopping. Me, sometimes I'll see him, I'll stop. I probably don't want to stop. But however, I mean, I'm always anticipating to hear from him. And another thing I like about him is the fact that he's so drawn to God. I like that. Anybody that is really drawn to God, I want to serve, that person automatically is my friend. And he has that quality and I like it. And I pray you keeping that one. Jesus name.
Thank you, ma. Thank you. Yeah, my bestie.
My bestie. Yeah,
my bestie. Sister Grace.
Okay.
Good
afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon. Can you hear me check? Is it?
Yes. stop talking.
We are sorry. Yeah, we are sorry.
What do you want to hear, my friend?
Yeah.
Okay, so how did I meet you? I think it was last year, around March, shortly before COVID. So I was looking for someone. Can you remember? I think I was looking for
Pelumi.
Pelumi. I know Pelumi. Yeah. So I was looking for Pelumi, and Pelumi is usually always outside around that kind of area. So I was asking him. I was like, "Do you know Pelumi?" And he said, "Yes." He said, "You know him and everything." So just, you know, I just liked the way he was able to answer my questions and, you know, everything. And I was like, this group, you know, he told me about the group. And I think we exchanged numbers then.
Yeah.
And from there, that's how we started talking. He added me to the group, and I became a member of the maturity team. But beyond that, he has been a very, you know, coincidentally, they made us bestie shortly after then. So, and he was always on my case. Even sometimes when I think that, can you just leave me alone? I have work to do. He's always there, he's understanding. When I, you know, I told him the kind of work I do, and I told him I'm not someone that likes to talk on the group chat, especially if I don't know the people there. I will not be able to talk so much, and if you understand it, yes, you'll be like, don't worry, I'll take your time, he understands, he will pray for you. He's there to listen. If I want to tell him anything, he always has that listening ear. He will not, if you understand, he's committed to God, like he's always like, okay, it's time for meeting. I don't know, he loves the things of God. I don't know how to put it in words. I just like everything about him. I like his personality too. He's so accommodating, he's so friendly, he's a giver. I don't know.
Movie's coming out, bro.
There are too many things to say. I'm just
God, bro.
I'm just grateful to have met him. And you know, the way he will be hyping me, bestie, my head is swelling.
Ginger is there.
So we are there for each other, bestie, no time. I pray for your life, and I pray that all your heart desires will be met this year. Everything you need, God will grant unto you. You know, those things that you need that will elevate you, that will take you to where you need to be, God is going to give it to you. Even as he has given you those two boys, there will be blessings to you, to your family, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, ma. Thank you so much, Anu. Thank you, my bestie. Mr. Keming.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Ah,
let me
see.
I went to like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, it was 2 weeks ago. The first time I met you was, you chatted, you know, it was on chat.
Yeah.
Then the Sunday following that.
We now met outside, yeah.
And that was the third Sunday in March.
Yeah.
A wedding.
Celebration.
Wow. But okay. The father of our two.
Wow.
The two instances that I am tapping into.
Wow.
He's a wonderful person.
Oh.
The 2 weeks I've met him, like, it looks like I've met him for a very, very long time. When you see the relationship, you think that people have met him like some. You don't know that it's just like some days, just 2 weeks ago. Once again, I want to wish you a happy birthday.
Wow. Thank you.
I pray that God grant you all your heart's desire.
Amen.
Speedily.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
They are 2 weeks old. So they will always be such a blessing.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I don't have anybody to cry over.
Amen.
Your wife, you God will always provide. Everything.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
You will not lack anything.
Amen.
It's going to be money, glory upon glory.
Amen.
We will always have resources and
grace. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Sister Kemi. Thank you. Now, Sister Grace.
Sister Grace, to round it up. I see on the game.
Ma?
So she's looking at the camera.
I don't understand. Okay, Bro Ope joined the HSDC like 5 years ago.
Are you serious?
Yes.
I'm 5 years old. Is this Corona now? It's Corona.
No, Corona is not stopping the videos. If you go to the video, you go to the panic.
Okay, so he joined our first class. He joined HSDC.
Yeah.
And in HSDC, we have structures. So he came to join Admin, and I was the head of Admin.
Wow.
So
I also served there too.
So,
Mr. Grace, you're going deep now.
I said that all day. It's good to be
deep.
First thing about him is that he's so reliable. Always available. You know, it's two different things. So he's always available. If there's anything to do, and you think of him, and you just tell him,
like
he has never made excuse
like
for us to go. That's the first thing about him. Then. When you think that you've loaded him too much, that's when you'll be asking for more to do. So I was like, okay, where is the lady coming from? Where? I was like, so that tells me that he loves God and he loves God's people.
Wow.
Yeah. And that is so great about him. And before COVID, so when we were asked to split from HSDC to, I think, like 4 departments, from 1 department, I was like, okay, forget about it. Me, I'm very shy. I'm one quiet person, easy going. But if I'm like him, you won't know me because in church, I will just greet you and come my way. I'm like him, like mingle with everybody. So, if I were to bring from HSBC, I was thinking, not that church has made me so. The way will I start from? I don't even know. Yeah, but somehow, God just told me, go with Ope. So we had choice of going with four people. I was like, go with Ope, don't worry, everything will be fine. So when everybody were fighting for him, because they know what he's capable of, I just said, no, you can take 100, but let me just go with him and maybe 3 other people. So out of those 3 other people, one has moved to Antony, one has moved to Ireland. So they were just the two.
Okay,
and Ope brought everybody that you can think of in the group. And now from group of 4, we are now 22.
Wow!
So you can invite everybody. So you've grown everybody, we just let this like race. Met somebody so wonderful. And that's how we find ourselves here. So it's an evangelist.
Yes.
Wow.
So I also want to say something about the group and Sir Grace.
Church just think something comes up, and they were just thinking we can do it, and they just think of our own thing. And I was like, okay, somebody I've not even met, I can't begin to say come and do things. I just say, bro, we say no problem. We wake up overnight to you. First time that next level started, we started the
conversation.
Yes. All those that they were doing now, including the prayer points, including the programs, including all the camera people and all of that, because that's what we are meant to be doing. Before they now properly set up we all started it from our team. Pastor Kamu was the one that was giving
does all of those things. So today, even wine press, over Zoom meetings.
Wow.
All of those short research. We were meant to do research, but research never came through because of timing and all of that. So we started from our team, but we thank God for everything. And I thank God for Bro Ope.
Thank you, ma'am.
One of the things I like about him, he doesn't box love things. But when you are going through some things at times, you need somebody to talk to. He will quickly send me a text message. Grace, this is how it's going. I'm just calm down, don't worry. Okay, let's do this. Everything will be. First of all, I've learned from you that even if I'm passing through challenges, you shouldn't push me away from God. You should only draw me more to God because there's no solution elsewhere.
Yeah.
No, you know, all these things can be overwhelming. At times, you get carried away and you just want to be in your shell. But reverse is okay. That's where you come closer to God.
Yeah.
So I've learned that challenges shouldn't draw you away from God. It should only bring you closer. And it's always on top of everything. Stagress, we're praying on Friday. Let's do this, let's do that. Sure. It's a good day to say thank you.
Thank you, Master Grace. I want to be here if not for her as well. A lot of people don't know. When I was down in this church, I didn't have anywhere to go. I just came into the church. I was using Touchlight's phone. It's that Grace will be chasing me crazily and be believing in me. Even when I don't believe in myself, I don't have any friend in the church, but it's that Grace will be on my neck. Like, I have Touchlight's phone. She will send me text message on what they're doing in the group. She will send me email. She will call me. She will follow up. I would like, nobody in the whole church knows me. They don't even want to care about me. But she's the only one that will be like, I want to know what's up about you. Why would you single me out among the whole crowd? So that just blew me up. Like, who is this woman being? And I just went crazy.
A round of applause for that.
So, she
it's a good day to also mention something for all of us. Yes, all those things that you mentioned, I was doing. You know, at times something will bring you to God, but you need something to keep you going.
Yeah.
And that's your creation. So over time, I've learned that serving God things. I've done that over the years, and I've seen God rewarding me for that. I can't begin to mention what God has done just because I have God. So I want to encourage everybody, don't wait until somebody chases you or something. Praying, studying should be the number one thing that all of us should do. And you know, if as maturity team, you want to help other people mature their Christianity by God, you have to be on top of your soul. Because what you don't have, everything. That's not the truth. So I don't want us to don't say that yes, but very active to join that you join. Look for something. Don't keep quiet. Don't wait till when you start chasing your government. If you see something that you don't think will be useful. Let's do that. Why I said we are young, we can build it together. Nobody knows it all. So please always remember that in the heart of service, that's where all the solution you are looking for lies. You see people serving God, they got married, you see people serving God. In fact, there was one Sister Grace in HSDC. Sister Grace, you know Sister Grace, I went to Canada.
She's back.
Yeah, she's back. She
was part of our cell before.
I was still at home.
Okay. She was part of my cell member before. Okay.
I thought she said she was going to be around
today. No. Sister Grace is been out there. So Sister Grace also, in fact, she was from nothing, but she was so convincing, serving God, and all of a sudden everything changes. She's even a single mother, you know, to drop out of school, she just came to harvest that because we are less judgmental, and that was it. So, from being homeless and all of that, but she believed in serving, and it was from this act of service that this virus man saw her and employed her, and from there she got this man that have
Not a cross.
Gave her a job, got admission to Canada, traveled to got sick. Came back, got married, and with kids now. Yes, who knows? I'm not saying it's going to be the same story for everybody, but I'm just saying, the first thing that we all look for is in this God's work, and there's no way you claim love God, and we all reflect the way you handle His things. So when you hear God's things, you should be awake, as they should be this silly that my father's business can be suffered. That's the way I say it. This to that God's business. If my ordinary job can only give me a source of income, it's not even my source of livelihood, because God is my provider. It's just a need. So I know the way I react when there's issues to me. So how much more God? So I love for God to reflect the way we are doing. Thank you.
No, thank you, Stan Grace. We love you. Thank you so much.
So now, like as I was saying, for.
Our mother in the love.
Our mother completed. Please. Don't call me
mother.
I'm your sister.
Like,
ah, mommy of the
house.
We do not accept. We do not accept.
She's our mommy.
Spiritual mommy.
Like, now, I want to say something. We all we are here celebrating Bro Ope. Bro Ope is a human. Do you understand? Nothing changes anybody from doing the same thing Bro Ope is doing to to transfer that same love to everyone among ourselves like this. Just like our mom. The day I saw her was the day she told us to officiate on signing the program. That day I was just like, I was just looking and said, she just like, you know what I'm trying to pass her? She's so humble. I mean, if you want to see the best in me, when you're humble, I'm ready to even lick your feet. I don't mind. Make me anything, give me any of it. I'm ready to be loyal to you because it's what you give me, that's what I'm reciprocating. Same as Bro Ope. So please, we as a team, with this man on our side, nobody can intimidate us in HSDC.